Hello everyone, this is Major Arlene reporting, and welcome back to Doom Mod Reviews. This is Doom Mod Review number 558. Wow, I was not expecting a demo. This is called Doomed for the Last Time, even though this is this author's first map. This was made in 2001, so we're gonna go ahead and get started before we get too much spoiled for us. So, they said, this person said this was based loosely off Duke Nukem 3D. I like this effect right here. What? Got the satellites over here, those good old satellite sprites that we saw in Doomed in Space. Got our shotgun. That's good. So now, once we do this, we should be good to go. Is the glass breakable? It is not. Darn. That's disappointing. I need to get a transparent texture that is actually, like, usable. Okay, so that opens up the door. So far, so good, actually. Yeah, it's a lot of gray and silver and stuff, but... I mean, you know. Gray and silver is actually not bad if used properly. What's that noise? Y'all heard it too, right? It's prickling noise. Okay, the bars aren't transparent and you can like walk right through them. I don't know if that was intentional, but I'm guessing it was. Good use of deep water. I mean, oh, the water makes some noise. That's even better. I can't go anywhere here, so okay, this is interesting. I like this. Oh, I see what it is. It's a silent teleport. I was so confused. I'm like, what is going on with this? Ooh, a machine gun. I'm gonna find my way out. Why is that thing on fire? Aww. This is gonna be a pain. Okay, got a rocket launcher. That is good. Okay. Don't know if it was really necessary in the grand scheme of things, but I guess we'll find out. That's just a good use of everything. Like, everything that's being done. So. That's good. Hello. I don't know what those switches do. No idea. It's just like a good use of environmental effects in this. I mean, it really is. There's definitely been effort put into this. And I do truly enjoy that. But we can't kick the toilets! That was like my favorite part of Duke Nukem. Ow. Hey! I was having a moment here. Why did all those monsters teleport in that way? That's a little disconcerting. It's all good. Oh. Well, I would have figured I would have needed a... The noise is not good. Don't like that sound, but that's okay. I mean, always about what I like. That's cool. I hope things aren't teleporting behind me, because that is my face. I unfortunately, I do have to say, I don't agree with the way that monsters are being, used in this. Because I would not teleport them all in here. That's a bad idea. Okay, this started off really great, and but now you're not giving me anything to work with. Yeah, I'm out. Oh my god. Yeah, that is the one thing this map is lacking, is ammo. Which is not good. Far. Aesthetically speaking, this is great. I love everything about this. However, you have got to give me ammo. Not only that, you need to actually place your monsters instead of just teleporting all of them in at one time. That ruins gameplay. I mean, it really does. I mean, I had hardly any kills before I came to get across this bridge. And that's where literally all my kills went. It was right there. That is definitely one thing I will complain about, because there's no reason to do that. I mean, you can place monsters anywhere you want to on this map. It's fucking huge. That whole thing right there is just kind of frustrating and annoying. I gotta figure out what I'm doing now. Not only that, like, you didn't really put any health in your map other than that armory area. The place up here looks like they need to go. Right here. So great. Now I don't have a red key, so where am I supposed to get the red key? I don't know. That door is bricked, it looks like. So, what am I supposed to do about this? I don't know. Don't get me wrong, the use of effects and stuff in here is great, but there's nothing here to really... Is there something over here I'm supposed to get? I don't know. It doesn't look like that's the case. There's nowhere to get a red key at. What are you trying to do here? I've been literally like everywhere, right? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Did I get it? I guess I did. Well, that's a totally dumb place to hide a key. That is a totally dumb place to put a key. I'm sorry, that is just really ridiculous. And there's nothing to indicate that that nukage is deep. Like, I mean, yeah, you use deep water, but... Sorry. I had such high expectations from this map, and I'm like, locked, find another way. Back into the ductwork I go. Can't wait. Wait, so what was the point of doing that? You would think with the door stuck like that you wouldn't be able to open it, but no. Okay, we're done. Okay, so... It wasn't terrible, just the way that we did the monsters in here was terrible. Like, if you have 130 monsters in your map, don't push them on me all at once. I mean, like, at least give me, I mean, yeah, I get having, like, some ambushes, but that was just obscene. I mean, pretty much 100 monsters coming at you all at once, and that's all the monsters you have in your map. I mean, that is kind of ridiculous to me. Other than that, this was a good map. The concept was very good. I wish we had done some stuff with, like, outdoor stuff. I mean, and I guess I should have realized with Duke Nukem being the inspiration that, yeah, we would have had deep nukage and stuff. But, I mean, it was kind of weird because the way that it was set up is he would introduce, like, sort of a concept to us and then... like, not give that same indication later, like, with the deep water and then the deep nukage. So, I don't know. I mean, it's kind of, I have mixed feelings about it. It was mostly good. But just the monster encounters and then where the red key was hidden was kind of ridiculous. So, anyway, that's all the time I have for the day, and I'll see you guys next time. Until then, this is Paige Arlene.